Well, hey there, Cecilia here, and it's Q&A Thursday. You've got questions, I've got answers, and today I'm going to go over the top four questions that I received over the last 7 days. All right, you can hear me okay. If you're watching me on LinkedIn and YouTube, feel free to fast forward to about minute three, give or take. But of course, once again, my name is Cecilia Morris. I am your engineer by education, home business owner by desire, and it is Q&A Thursday, where I will share with you answers to some of the most asked questions I got this week. And if you have questions and you're watching me here live, then feel free to type your question in the chat and I'll try to give you an answer as well. Well, hey, Trina, how are you? Thank you so much for joining in. No, I still haven't got my hair. That's a running joke for those who don't know. But anywho, Trina, I'm happy to have you here. So from a business perspective, as I said, my name is Cecilia. I help affiliate and network marketers learn how to use digital marketing strategies to build their brand and business online. And I've been doing this for the last couple of years. And the results and the help that I have been able to provide and the gratification I get from helping others has been super, super amazing. And I've been in network marketing / home-based business arena for over 10 years. So I have transitioned into the digital world. So with that, everything shared, let's get to it. If you are watching me live and you get value from this video, please feel free to like, comment, and share with those that you know, especially since I'm still in Facebook jail, so I can't share myself. All right, so the first question, and this actually, you know what? At first it made me mad because it came up three times this week, in the last 7 days, three times. Why does everything cost? Okay, so let's talk about what cost you for real, for real. How much did those Beyonce tickets cost if you happen to go to her On the Run 2 tour with Jay-Z? You didn't flinch about paying that $200, did you? Or how much was that dinner that you had at Red Lobster since they got crap this? I bet you didn't flinch about that cost, did you? So what I found out in talking with my accountability partners and my mentor is that people really aren't, they aren't complaining about the cost. The real complaint is they don't feel like they're worthy of their investment. When I went to school for engineering, I couldn't negotiate with Purdue about the cost. The cost was the cost was the cost. Either I pay it or I don't get an engineering degree, or I go somewhere else and get an engineering degree. But that's just what it is. It's the cost of doing business. Also, you have to remember, and this happened to me talking to clients that had asked for personal coaching sessions. Now I give everybody a free initial, I shouldn't say everybody, but for those who request my help, I give them an initial consultation where we talk about where they're at in their business, where they want to go, and if I can help them get there. Oh, and before I forget, if you watch the replay, give me a hashtag replay. And if you are jumping on live, give me your name and say hello so I can say hello back. So anyway, so I have three clients, potential clients. That's one of the things I love about this business. I get to pick who I want to work with, whereas in a traditional job, you have to work with whoever they throw you with. So I get to pick. So that's part of the consultation. I talk to you and find out where you're at. You tell me where you want to go. We talk about whether or not we can work together and decide. I get to decide. Well, I guess they do too, but I make the final say on whether or not I think we're a good fit to work together. But I have decided through the training that I've gotten, if you balk at the cost of investing in yourself, then no, we are not a good fit. So for example, there was a call I had on, I believe it was Sunday, and the lady that I was speaking with was in a traditional network marketing company where she had to sell products each month and had to maintain a minimum order requirement. She wanted to go online and wanted to be digital, but she did not have a clue. And when I told her the cost of my package, she actually hung up, like literally click up. So at first I was like, but then I was like, you know what? She wouldn't have been a good fit for me anyway. Because if you don't want to invest in yourself to get the knowledge that you need to grow and build your business online, well, then I and a whole lot of people out there cannot help you. I've got tons of free resources out there. I've got videos. I've got blogs on my website. I've got free items on my resources. resources page of my website. But if you want my personal one-on-one attention, then it's going to cost you as it would anything else. So it's not. So the question is, oh, and then, so that was Sunday. And then yesterday, I'm sorry, let me go back. Tuesday, I was talking to a client, a potential client, and she told me that she could not afford it right now. So she gave me this whole laundry list of stuff that's going on in her life. And I said, you know what? And she had children. So this was a good example. I was like, if one of your children was in the hospital and there was only one drug available, but it wasn't on your insurance and it cost you $10,000 to get that drug that would save your child, would you come up with the $10,000? And she was like, oh, well, of course I would. That's my baby. Well, that's how you need to feel about yourself and your business. Your business is your baby. If your desire is to get some extra income, if your desire is to quit your job, whatever that want, need, desire is that you have, then you have to be willing to invest in yourself. And it's a business expense. It's not like my college. I can't write off my student loans on my taxes, but I can write off my business expenses. So it's not that everything costs. It's that if you want knowledge, you pay attention when you pay out of your pocket. And the more you pay, the more you pay attention. That is what it is. A lot of free stuff is out there and even paid stuff, and people pay for it and they never do another thing. But those who really put their money where their mouth is are the ones that are serious about making positive changes in their lives. So don't look at the cost of something like, oh, that's too much, or what am I getting for this? If you think you're getting the value for your dollar, then spend that dollar or more, because at the end of the day, nobody's going to do it for you. And if you want to browse around and Google search and find all the free resources on the internet and spend your time and energy when you can have a nice little package wrapped up in a neat little bow handed to you for a price that's really nominal compared to the value that you're going to get. Let me give you an example again. So those are two of the three calls that I had this week where they balked at the price. And then I won't tell you about the third call, but I will say, if I didn't make a $3,000 investment in myself in 2016, I probably wouldn't be having this conversation with you right now. And the conversation and the value that I provide is definitely something that will get you on the right path, because I've helped so many people already. So that was a great investment for you, for me, and whatever you invest in to improve yourself, to live your dream, to get the needs that you have, that you want to get filled, done, you got to invest. So don't look at it as, why does everything cost? Look at it as, what is the value I'm getting for my money? That's question number one. Question number two, what is the difference between affiliate and network marketing? So affiliate marketing is where you are basically taking a product that someone has allowed you to sell and selling that, and then you get a commission from selling that product. You don't have to build a team. You don't have to have people underneath you. You just have to sell that product. And that is the broad stroke of affiliate marketing. If you want more detail, Google it. But I did get asked that a lot this week, so I wanted to put that out there. So affiliate marketing is where you earn a commission selling what someone else has allowed you to sell in your name, but you earn a commission off of it. You're not responsible for this. You're not responsible for the physical or information products. You're not responsible for shipping or distribution. You're not responsible for even taking their credit card information. All that is handled through the affiliate company that you're working with. Whereas with network marketing, you either have a product, be a physical product you can hold in your hand, or you have an intangible product that is providing value and giving them something that they need. Giving your client, I should say, something that they need. And then you're building a team. And then you have the opportunity to earn residual income off of the efforts of your team. So with the network marketing, you're actually building a network of people that are doing the same thing that you're doing. And you're able to earn an income off of not only your work, but their work as well. And so that, once again, is the broad brushstroke of affiliate and network marketing. Now, there are some affiliate programs that are kind of hybrids of network marketing. I'm not going to name a few, but they are out there. And if you want some of those, comment affiliate in the comments, and I can give you a name of some affiliate programs that have some of the same properties, for lack of a better term, of network marketing, meaning that you don't have to build a team, but if you are an affiliate and you sell a program and that person also becomes an affiliate, you can earn income off of the affiliate sales that they make as well. But once again, it's not required with affiliate marketing. That's just an extra bonus or benefit that some programs have where it is required in network marketing. So number three, how do I determine my ideal client? So this was a call with the client I had earlier this week. And one of the things we discussed, she wanted to talk about ads, and she was so gung-ho to run Facebook ads. She's like, I just want to run a Facebook ad. I know if I advertise this, then I will get the leads that I want. And I was like, well, who are you advertising to? And she could not tell me who her target market is. Do not, I repeat, I do not spend $1 on advertising until you know who it is you are advertising to. Who is that person that you're marketing to? Who is your ideal client? If you want to know my blueprint, which I'm going to talk to you about here shortly, comment ideal client and I will send you the PDF. But some of the things that you need to think about for your ideal client are, what are their problems? Well, first of all, what's their age range? That's first and foremost, because everybody is not your client. And I have to say that over and over again. Everybody is not your client. You determine who your ideal customer is by one, what is the age range of the person that you want to work with? Number two, what are their problems or struggles? What is it that keeps them up at night? Number three, what are their dreams, their wants, their needs, their desires? Basically, what is it that they want to fix that problem? Then you want to look at what types of things are they already consuming? Could it be books? Could it be magazines? Is it all online? Where are those people? Because where they are will determine, like she wants to do Facebook ads, but maybe her ideal client isn't on Facebook. Something to think about. And then you want to look at the competition. Who out there offers what it is that you have, and how are they marketing? What are they doing? What type of results are they getting? And you can find all that out by doing you can't find out the problems, struggles, dreams, and desires. That you're going to have to think through yourself. But as far as what your competition is doing, you can, and how they're doing, by the way, you can find that out on Google. So that is answer to question number three. And if you want my ideal client worksheet, comment ideal client and I will send you over the PDF. Then there's number four. What do I talk about with my audience? And this was a gentleman that I had a client call with earlier this week. Actually, it was yesterday. I had a client call with him and I was telling him how he needs to go live because there was a webinar we did yesterday with Daryl Eves. And he is a super, super guru at YouTube marketing. And he did a webinar last night. And so I did a little pitch telling people that they needed to attend that webinar. So anyway, we talked after the webinar and his whole thing is that he is just uncomfortable going live. He's like, I don't know what to say and I don't want to look stupid and all that. So I have two websites for you that will give you ideas. I already did a post earlier this week. I think it was on Tuesday about 27 Facebook post ideas. But when you go live, if you want something to talk about, there's two websites that are out there that can give you some ideas of what to talk about when you go live. The first one is Quora, Quora.com. That is a question and answer website. Look at the questions that are being asked there and just pick one and then talk about it when you go live. And another one is Answer the Public. That's right, answerthepublic.com. So as an example, this is one where you can type in a topic and then they'll tell you what people are asking. So I went to answerthepublic.com and I typed in network marketing. Just by typing in network marketing, 116 questions came up. So if all I ever wanted to do was talk about network marketing, that's 116 videos that I could do because there's 116 questions on answerthepublic.com. So if you're struggling on what it is to talk about on your lives, provide value by answering questions. Type in a subject, answerthepublic.com, and then pick one of those questions, Google it, and then talk about it. And then there's also Quora, Q-U-O-R-A.com, where you can see the questions that people are asking as well. I personally like Answer the Public better, but that's neither here nor there. So with that being said, that is the answer to the number four top question I had over this past 7 days. And if you've got questions and you're watching the replay, go ahead and type your questions in the comments. I'll try and get you some answers. You can message me and it'll be on next Thursday. If you can't attend live, then just watch the replay and your question will get answered. So I hope that helps you as you go through the next 7 days. Remember, Thursday is my Q&A day. I thank you for your time. I'm Cecilia Morris, your engineer by education, home business owner by desire. And today's assignment is, if you are struggling in your network or affiliate marketing business and you want to have a one-on-one free call with me to talk about where you're at, where you want to go, and how I can help you get there, we can have that call. I will put the link into the comments so that way you have it there. But yeah, go ahead and schedule some time with me. This first one is free and the next one will cost you. I'm Cecilia. Have a great day. Till next time.